Facts Radio, and this is the recap of Wilder Ortiz 2. Deontay Bomb Squad Wilder, born October 22nd, 1985, and he is the ultimate American professional boxer. His WBC record stands at 40 knockouts, and what we just seen was him securing his boxing legacy against Ortiz. What a fucking fight. We about to recap it right now. The very first time I seen or heard anything about Deontay Wilder, and the clips just keep running back in my mind, he was like, this Haitian is about to take a permanent vacation. And that was 2015. And since then, he's been a WBC champion, standing over the others with a golden sword. And this time, it was even more official. He walks into the MGM Grand Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, and this time he had to face the WBA interim heavyweight champion, the challenger, which is one of the greatest fighters coming out of Cuba. This motherfucker got hands, man. Luis Ortiz ain't no motherfucking joke. And the Bomb Squad leader had to show up and show out. Dressed as the Bomb Squad warlord of the WBC division, Wilder standing 6'7", he comes out of the MGM Grand Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, dripped up and dressed to the nines. I don't know what kind of outfit this motherfucker had on, but let's just say he was sharp, man. He looks like he was something fresh out of the Game of Thrones. He was player number one in the game, and he meant all the business, and he wanted all the smoke. And then Ortiz comes from the back, dead ass serious. I mean, you could even look at Ortiz in the... You could look at the face that he was wearing, you know, that certain look that he was wearing. You could tell he was an ultimate fighter straight up out of Cuba. You could tell that his last 12 weeks of training was no motherfucking game. He was dead ass and he was looking for victory early. The first round started and it looked like it was just a filling out process, you know. And by the end of the first round, it clearly went to Ortiz, but there was no dap at the end of the bell. That let me know that we was off to the races and this was going to be a good fight. Both fighters that come out of round two, still a filling out process. You see that Wilder leading a lot with that left jab. And it seems like in the second round that only Ortiz was connecting. I mean, by the end of the second round, I had both rounds going to Ortiz. But you could see in Bomb Squad's leader's eyes that he was watching him. A couple of times I see Ortiz, I'm not sure if he tried to step on Wilder's toes, but a couple of times they jammed up. You can obviously see that both fighters had a lot of movements, a lot of head movements, a lot of feints, a lot of jabs, and you could tell that they both been trained to kill. By the top of the third coming out, I had Ortiz clearly winning 2-0, and it came into the third and Wilder hits Ortiz with a shocking right hand to the chest. Well, he pounds his chest pretty damn good. And that's like the only highlight in the third round. Ortiz clearly got the round again. And by the end of the third round, you hear the crowd start to turn on him a little bit. You hear a little bit of the boos. Sometimes we as the fans, man, we love the blood and the guts. We weren't really understanding that this was a filling out process. You know, both fighters, they got to collect that data. They got to put all the information in their database going into the later rounds. And when the fourth round started, boy, it started to get good. Ortiz caught him with a nice left-right combination, and Wilder hit him with a little smile as if he knew that now they were about to start cranking it up. The crowd started rising, and we were off to the races. At that time, I still had Ortiz winning the race 4-0. And by the top of the fifth, it had to be something very, very, very different. It had to be a change, let's just say that. Wilder had to switch it up in the fifth. And he also connected with a straight left two times. And I seen in his eyes that it might be a transitional point. I mean, hell, at this point in time, I got Ortiz up 5-0 clearly. And the sixth was damn the same. I mean, Ortiz catches him with a pretty ass jab, and it shows that Ortiz has to be the best heavyweight fighter in the world. He moves like water. His fluidity is crazy. I mean, I haven't seen a heavyweight move like Ortiz ever at this time. And after the sixth round, if it was to end on the sixth round, Ortiz would have mopped the floor with Deontay Wilder. And then suddenly, the tides have changed. The start of the seventh round starts off, and The crowd, as well as I, we all felt it was going to be the same thing. But boy, did they start mixing it up. Wilder hits him with a, starts mixing him up and hit him with a clear left jab. I said, uh-oh, it's about to go down. And then the right hand from the gods rang out. And in the seventh round, Wilder gets a knockout victory over Ortiz. And it was just like that, the 10th title defense from the Bomb Squad warlord, Deontay Wilder. And much like Wilder says in his post-press conference, bam, baby, good night. It was over. And it was another title defense for Deontay Bomb Squad Wilder. And Wilder Fury 2 is on the way. February 2020, it stands to be one of the biggest fights in the WBC WBO history. It is going down, and I wouldn't miss it for the world. The most devastating knockout artist in the game, Deontay Wilder, against the most chauvinistic, coolest motherfucker in the game named Fury. It's gonna be big. Don't forget to like, follow, subscribe, share. Show Nasty Triple X Radio. I am your host, Kim Velez Pierre. Stay tuned, stay locked, stay down. Go!